Sri Harivamsaji, Deputy Chairman, Rajya Sabha. Sri MP Veerendra Kumar, member of our house as well as Managing Director, Chairman of Matrubhumi Publications, and also the author of the book, Sri P.V. Chandran, Managing Editor, Matrubhumi Publishing House, Sri M.V. Srayams Kumar, Joint Managing Director, Matrubhumi, Srimati Ranjana Sen Gupta, Srimati Usha Veerendra Kumar, Sri D. Raja, my friend, Secretary Communist Party, Sri Sampath, Sri Jairam Ramesh. I think Veerendra Kumar has brought everybody together from Sridharan Pillai, from BJP to Congress to Communist. So good. He's a great unifier that way. What is required in the country is unity and respect for each other. And my dear brothers and sisters, we have all made it today, this evening, for this good program of releasing of the book written by Sri M.P. Veerendra Kumarji. Yadavarkum Inde Namaskaram. Ningade Yadavarium Uparashtrapati Bhavanike Swagatam Chayanum. Parliament Angavum Bohumaka Pratibhavi Mama Sri M.P. Veerendra Kumar Rachicha Haimavati Bhuvil Yanna Pustakatinde English Pratipa Prakasanam Chayatadil Santosha Undu. I feel really happy to release Himalayan Odyssey, the English translation of the Malayalam original, Haimavathabhuvil. I am glad that the book first published in Malayalam by Matrubhumi Books has won the coveted Kendra Sahitya Academy and Kerala Sahitya Academy Awards. The other honors include Murthy Devi Puraskar, Dr. Sivaram Karanth Award, Vailar Award and Amrita Kirti Puraskaram and many more. The English version of the travelogue captures the grandeur, the civilizational ethos and culture of India in all its glory, and I must compliment Sri Veerendra Kumarji for the excellent work done. Indeed, the book is about India's legends, mythologies, history, biography, culture, arts, spirituality and politics, capturing the fecund diversity of Indian civilization. With the core theme of various journeys made into the Himalayan Chardhams, the book takes in its grand sweep everything from the snow-capped Himalayan peaks to the banks of the river Neda in Kerala. The book talks of the spiritual evolution of our heritage from the Himalayan Devabhumi to Veda Bhumi of the banks of Neela, meditation on Krishna, the subtle concepts of Radha Krishna and Ras Leela, and their deep-rooted hold on the narrative, imagination and poetic charm of Gita, Govindam by Jayadev. Beginning with the author's journey to the Himalayas from Delhi in October 2003, it recounts his long association with the capital and talks of the mythological origins of Indraprastha and the hoary legend of Kurukshetra. Tracing the historic events unfolded on the banks of Yamuna from the times of Delhi Sultanate to the makings of Imperial Retains Delhi, it touches on the Hindu, Mughal, Islamic, Jain, Buddhist influences on the electric architecture. Among others, the writer mentions the landmark Stockholm Convention in the context of pollution in the city of Ghaziabad and Meerut's historic link to Alexander. The mythological links to Mahabharata and its role in the first war of India's independence. After dwelling into the contribution of philosopher poet, grammarian Bhartruhari, the work turns philosophical. The hallowed land of Kankal, the concept of Ardhanariswara, the Haridwar declaration to save Ganga in 2002 in the context of Tehri Dam displacement, the earlier efforts by Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia and references to various holy temples in the region are also found in this book. The book also talks of the sacred Ganges with its perennial hold on the Indian imagination, with poets, scientists and travelers lauding its mystical qualities. Apart from mentioning about Gangotri, the author refers to the retreat of the Gomukh Glacier. Sounding an environmental alert, he also quoted many scientific studies on global warming. The history of Tehri Garhwal, global ecological impact of massive dams, the origins of music through Tansen to the little known musical bent of Swami Vivekananda, the sacred nature of Kedarnath with its centrality to Shaivite faith, and the journey to the holy dham of Kedarnath are all interestingly penned by the author. The book also talks of the eventful Kailash trek of the head monk of Vasishta Guha, the architectural marvel of the Baidyanath temple dating back to the Kathiuri dynasty on the banks of the Gomati River, and ruminates on the concept of Devi as the high point of the feminine principle. The final chapter is a summation of the summarization of the journey through both space and time, undertaken with a band of near and dear ones, with a Kosani, hometown to nationalist poet Sumitranandan Pant, and Anashakti Ashramam, triggering a wave of thoughts on Gandhian philosophy and its abiding relevance for all times. Finally, I would like to stress the importance of promoting both domestic and international tourism and bringing out more travel books in India. My dear brothers and sisters, from Kanyakumari to Kashmir, India has many scenic and pilgrimage destinations with relevance to Indian history, culture, heritage, mythology. There is a great scope and a need to develop tourist circuits on specific themes to attract the tourists having special interest in visiting such places. Tourism is a major engine for economic growth and for creation of employment in sectors like hospitality, transport, and empowers local communities. While the central and state governments are doing their bit to develop tourist spots and promote tourism, I would like to suggest to the corporate sector also to supplement the efforts of the governments. I compliment the government for introducing schemes such as Swadeshi Darshan, National Mission for Pilgrimage Regeneration and Spiritual Augmentation Drive, called as Prasad, and also Railway Ministry for launching special pilgrimage packages. I feel that, as suggested by Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Bhai Modi, people, especially the youth, must visit at least 15 tourist destinations within India by 2022 to give boost to domestic tourism. By going around the country, you will be knowing India. You will be knowing the history. You will be knowing the culture. You will be knowing the heritage. That will really help you. Whether it is a religious pilgrimage, or a tourist pilgrimage, or even a political pilgrimage, that gives you knowledge. I can just tell you out of my own experience, one of the reasons for my coming up in public life has been intensely touring around the country, right from my younger days. It may be a surprise to you, I covered around 582 districts of the country, spent time there. Right from my student days, ABVP, National Secretary, then to Youth Wing President, National Vice President, State President, National Vice President, General Secretary, State, General Secretary, National, President, State, and President, National, Rural Development Minister to Urban Development Minister. One important thing I have done is going around the country, meeting, greeting, talking, walking, spending time with the people. That gives you real understanding of the country and its people, their problems, their aspirations, and challenges before the country and the system. That's why the tourism is not just for just going around and seeing, it is to understand the country. It will enable you greater knowledge and gives you more confidence, authenticity, to speak about your country, your motherland. So that's why this decision, the advice of the Honorable Prime Minister that we should do internal tourism. So many people nowadays, of course, tourism is the rise. Small things also, people try to go to Dubai, people try to go to Singapore, spend weekend there and all. I have no problem. Want to go to Dubai, go. There's no problem at all. But there are a lot of important places, places of importance within the country, where one must really go and see the beauty of the country. Beautiful scenes are available around the country, in different states. Every state has got something special. And that inspires you. Certain places give you inspiration. When you visit, when you spend time, you will get a sort of inspiration. And you get new thoughts, new ideas. And also you get sometimes new answers also to the problems. Because India, we are a developing country. We have got a demographic dividend. 65% of the people of the country are below 35 years. This is a big opportunity for us, and as well as big challenge also. Because the youth are aspirational. Earlier, people used to wait. I would like to tell the politicians also. I was also in politics till the other day. Now, of course, I'm retired from politics, but not tired from public life. I can tell the people's aspirations are increasing day by day. Earlier, they used to give 50 years to a party. Now, aisa nahi chale. Maximum 5 years or 10 years. People's expectations are high. Unless you work hard and try to understand their expectations and try to reach those expectations, you will not be able to succeed. This has to be understood by one and all. So intense study of the people's problems and their living conditions for the politicians, for the policy makers, and also for the people. You should know, that's why sometimes our friends from routines Delhi, they go wrong. Because if you just start thinking from here, imagining from here, without going around and then reaching out to the people, understanding their changed psychology, changed sometimes. Because this is always, this is a transformation that's going on. And the entire world, the globe, has become a small village now. So you will know what is happening everywhere within a few minutes or few hours. So that being the case, we must really come out with solutions to the problems faced by the people. And some of the solutions you can find in history. Some of the solutions you can find in heritage. Some of the solutions you can find, as I told you, by going around and knowing the history of each and every place and then going back to the past and understanding what has happened, how it has happened, etc. So that's why I say that this tourism of any kind is very, very important. Undertaking Bharat Darshan by students would be a good learning experience for them on various facets of Indian culture, heritage, languages, cuisines, and enhance their understanding of the unique cultural mosaic of the country. Recently, I was in Baltic countries, Lithuania, Latvia, Estonia and all. The Estonia is such a small country. I think 12 lakhs or 15 lakh population. It is totally digital. The first digital country in the world. I was discussing with those heads of the states. They told me, sir, we like India. For three reasons. One, they said, one, culture. Second is cuisine. Indian food also is popular across the globe. Though some of us, we are tempted by the Western food and then we go to pizzas and our children go to pizza, burger and all. I'm cautioning them everywhere because the recent publications, international publications says food habits and lifestyle changes are having major effect on spread of non-communicable diseases. So we have to really think about lifestyle changes. That's why this Fit India call and all, it's not for Fit India or yoga or some exercise is required for everybody. Second is the food habits. Our boys are all now, certain sections of them are developing craze for, they say, sir, it's instant food. I tell them, instant food means constant disease. One has to understand. How can the food be instant? Food has to be cooked. In Indian conditions, you go to different states, the food there is prepared according to seasons and reasons and conditions and climate of that state. And it is time tested for years together by our forefathers. They enjoyed it. And now we are running after this westernization. If something is good from west also, there is no problem. If that is the best. But only thing is just following it because of fascination or some publicity and branding and all. You go to a restaurant, also cards are made in such an attractive way. Food items also are named. Food items, the name is, they give different names which are attractive. And we have our own good names also. And we forget chicken 65 days. And your age is not even 25. You want to eat 65. So that you can get into early 65 or not. I have see these youngsters, they should be told about the value of eating homemade food and also Indian type of food. Their food is good for them in those countries. I'm not ridiculing it. Their conditions, their weather, their climate, their traditions, their system and all. But here in India, so this, you go around the country, you will appreciate how many thousands of varieties are there. And each state has got something special, even in food also. And they told me for this culture, cuisine and cinema. Indian cinema also is a great attraction across the globe. They're attracting people. Because of our, the way we produce films and also we pass on the messages, etc. and all. As a matter of fact, the corporate bodies like CAA, FICCI, ASSOCHAM should identify tourism places which are less developed and fund their development and beautification from pilgrim tourism to adventure tourism, from eco-tourism to wellness tourism. Wellness tourism. When we talk about Kerala, wellness tourism is very important. I'm going to Kozhikode, your place, on 24th. I'm going Kottakkal, Vaidyasala. World famous that way. Incredible India has plenty to offer. Wherever possible, PPP model should be implemented to make India one of the most attractive global tourist destination. I would like to once again compliment Sri MP Veerendra Kumar ji for penning this fascinating book. He's a multifaceted personality and wears many hats. Former Union Minister who had served in the cabinets of Sri Deyagowda ji and Sri I.K. Gujral ji. He's a prolific writer and authored several books. I'm told that he was conferred more than 100 awards, including the Kendra and Kerala Sahitya Academy Awards and the Murthy Devi Award instituted by Bharatiya Jnanapeeth. As the chairman and managing director of the Matrubhumi Printing and Publishing Company Limited, he has made an immense contribution to the field of journalism. Even as I see him in parliament with his health problems and all, he makes it to the house, waits for his turn, and makes his own contribution on every important aspect the house discusses, as and when, of course, it discusses. So the one message is of the book is that we must take care of the nature. The climate change is a great danger awaiting the humanity. There are champions like Ramesh, climate change experts and all. We have to educate the people. We must counsel the younger generation about their own personal habits. We used to respect the nature. So nature used to respect us. We started disregarding the nature. So nature also is now showing its fury on us, what is happening around the country and all. So that's why I always say, love and live with the nature. Nature, culture, together for a better future. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.